Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 19th of November. Four terrorists neutralized in gunfight with security forces in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan discusses peace process with Afghan President Ghani. And Sri Lanka's intelligence network has been reassembled, says President Gotabaya. And now for all the details. Four suspected Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorists who were hiding in a truck were killed in an encounter with security forces near Nagrota town in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Thursday morning. According to the police, it is likely that the terrorists were planning a big attack and that they were headed towards the Kashmir Valley.
Indian security forces killed four terrorists in Jammu region of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory on Thursday. Two policemen were also reportedly injured in the gunfight that ensued after the truck carrying terrorists was stopped for checking at a toll booth near Nagrota and the terrorists attacked the security personnel, Inspector General Jammu Zone Mukesh Singh said. Police also recovered huge cache of arms and ammunition from the slain terrorists. Reportedly, the terrorists were going towards Kashmir Valley from Jammu, planning for a big operation in the region during local polls that begin later this month. The militants are suspected to be from Pakistan-based militant outfit Jaish-e-Mohammed.
See, this encounter started at around 5 a.m. in the morning when the police and CRPF party started searching a truck. In this encounter, four terrorists were killed subsequently, and a large quantity of arms and ammunition was recovered. The arms and ammunition recovered includes 11 AK-47 rifles and 3 pistols, 29 grenades.
Meanwhile, Pakistan Rangers violated ceasefire in the Harinagar sector of Jammu and Kashmir's Kathua district on the intervening night of Wednesday and Thursday and targeted residential areas of Maniari village. A woman suffered serious bullet injuries in the firing when a mortar blasted in their house. Several other houses were partially damaged.
Amid an alarming surge in coronavirus infections in the Indian capital that have crossed the 500,000 mark, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal on Thursday presided over an all-party meeting to review the situation. Kejriwal later announced an increase in fine for not wearing mask and also urged people to celebrate ongoing Chhath Puja festival inside homes amid concerns of virus spread.
As the coronavirus infections have surged past 500,000 in the Indian capital, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal on Thursday presided over an all-party meeting to review the situation. The meeting of all political parties came a day after New Delhi recorded 7,486 fresh COVID-19 cases along with 131 new deaths, its highest single-day death toll due to coronavirus since the pandemic started, taking the overall death toll to 7,943. Although elsewhere in the country, new cases are falling, the situation is different in Delhi, where crowds have continued to throng markets in large numbers since the festive season began this month. Kejriwal later on Thursday announced the Delhi government has increased the fine for not wearing mask to Rs 2000 from 500. Expressing concern, he also urged people to celebrate the ongoing Chhath Puja festival at home instead of gathering near water bodies to take holy dip, a part of the rituals.
Chhath Puja manaye, apne apne ghar pe manaye, bahar ek saath kisi bhi talab ya kisi bhi aisi water body mein ek saath na utre, kyunki agar hum utre to sabko ek saath corona ho sakta hai.
The Delhi government, however, has made it clear that no fresh lockdown will be imposed in the capital amid raging speculation, but said that certain restrictions may be imposed in market areas for some days to curb the spread of COVID-19 in case such a need arises.
In news from Afghanistan, Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan arrived in Afghanistan's capital Kabul on Thursday on his first official visit to meet with President Ashraf Ghani and other Afghan leaders to discuss the Afghan peace process and bilateral ties. This is Imran Khan's first visit to Afghanistan since assuming office in August 2018. Pakistan's Foreign Ministry, in a statement on Wednesday, said that the focus would be on further deepening the fraternal bilateral relations between Afghanistan and Pakistan, the Afghan peace process, and the regional economic development and connectivity. At a time when peace negotiations between the Afghan government and Taliban representatives have stalled in Doha and violence is rising, Khan's visit is crucial for both the countries. His visit comes after the Pentagon announced this week that it would reduce the number of U.S. military personnel in Afghanistan from 4,500 to 2,500 by mid-January. Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz leader Maryam Nawaz on Wednesday tore into Prime Minister Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf party for rigging Gilgit-Baltistan elections and said that no one in Pakistan was ready to accept the fake election result. Meanwhile, protests have continued in the illegally occupied region over irregularities in the poll process.
Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz or PMLN Vice President Maryam Nawaz on Wednesday tore into Prime Minister Imran Khan's ruling PTI, the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf party, for rigging Gilgit-Baltistan elections and said that no one in Pakistan was ready to accept the fake election result. The complete but unofficial results of Sunday's elections indicate that PTI has emerged as the single largest party in the illegally occupied region. Maryam said that she had stayed in Gilgit-Baltistan for 8 to 10 days for the election campaign, and during that time the region was only voicing support for PMLN Supremo Nawaz Sharif.
वो सीटें भी मुस्लिम लीग नून के तोड़े हुए उम्मीदवारों की मरहून मिन्नत है।
Meanwhile, Pakistan People's Party chairperson Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has also alleged irregularities and said he will use all legal options against the open and naked rigging. Protests have continued in Gilgit-Baltistan since the results were announced. The elections were held despite protests by people of Gilgit-Baltistan against Pakistan's illegal occupation of the region.
In news from Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has said he has delivered on a key election promise to rebuild the island nation's intelligence network in the years since assuming office. The former wartime defense chief won the presidency after promising to end the spread of Islamist extremism in Sri Lanka following the deadly Easter Sunday bombings in 2019. Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa, in a televised address on Wednesday, said he had delivered on a key election promise, that is to rebuild the island nation's intelligence network in the years since assuming office. The former wartime defense chief won the presidency after promising to end the spread of Islamist extremism in the country following the deadly Easter Sunday bombings in April 2019 that killed more than 250 people.
බලයට පත් වූ පසු රටේ ආරක්ෂක අංශවලට සුදුසු නිලධාරීන් පත්කොට ඔවුන්ගේ වගකීම් නොපිරිහෙලා ඉටු කරන්නට බලය ලබා දුන්නා. කඩාවැටී තිබූ බුද්ධි අංශ ප්‍රතිව්‍යුහගත කොට ඒවා යලි පනගන්වන්නට කටයුතු කළා. ඒ අනුව මොනම ආකාරයේ හෝ අන්තවාදයකට යලි හිස එසවීමට ඇති ඉඩකඩ අපි පාලනය කර තිබෙනවා.
Gotabaya is the younger brother of current Sri Lankan Prime Minister and former President Mahinda Rajapaksa, and the two led the country to victory against separatist Tamil rebels a decade ago after a 26-year civil war. Immensely popular among Sri Lanka's Sinhala Buddhist majority, Gotabaya himself has been accused of war crimes, but he has denied the allegations. Human rights groups have expressed fears of a surge in Buddhist nationalism and violation of fundamental rights under his administration. Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal's Prime Minister and co-chair of the Nepal Communist Party, KP Sharma Oli, will be presenting a report after 10 days in reply to another co-chair, Pushpa Kamal Dahal's 19-page proposal about the party's internal affairs. This comes as the long-awaited brief secretariat meeting of the ruling NCP was held on Wednesday.
Nepalese Prime Minister and co-chair of the Nepal Communist Party, KP Sharma Oli, will be presenting a report after 10 days in reply to his party co-chair Pushpa Kamal Dahal's 19-page proposal about their party's internal affairs. This comes as the long-awaited brief secretariat meeting of the ruling NCP was held on Wednesday afternoon. Considering Oli's proposal, the next meeting will now take place on November 28, NCP spokesperson Narayan Kaji Shrestha has informed. The secretariat will be discussing the documents and proposals and resolve the crisis, as the Dahal faction has demanded Oli's resignation, accusing him of failure on multiple fronts and ignoring party decisions. Oli is under pressure to reconcile his differences with the rival faction within his party, as he is in minority in all the key bodies of the party, the Secretariat, Standing Committee and Central Committee.
A young Afghan woman has opened an art gallery in capital Kabul with an aim to revive the use of felt, a traditional textile in art, to showcase her war-torn country's creativity and to try to create jobs for young people hit hard by the pandemic and the economic crisis it has caused. At a small gallery in Afghanistan's capital, Faika Sultani carefully dips a brush in paint before applying it to a felt canvas propped up on an easel. 27-year-old Sultani said she had been feeling depressed due to being out of work for nearly 2 months, a problem made worse by the coronavirus lockdown earlier this year, until she joined art enterprise Namath Company about a month ago. Painting has helped.
من نقاشی میکنم از بروز احساساتم روی کنواس یا روی کاغذ یا نمد فرق نمیکنه. لذت میبرم. و نقاشی روی نمد بر من اینو نشون میده که ما میتونیم سنت قدیم دوباره زنده بسازیم و بر مردم نشان بدیم که ما میتونیم از داشته‌های افغانی خودمون استفاده بکنیم و زندگی خودمون را رنگی‌تر و زیباتر بسازیم.
21-year-old Panahi set up the Namath Gallery at the height of the coronavirus pandemic in September. Panahi currently employs 10 people, including 3 artists.
نمد با یک کانسپت شروع شد و شروع نمد از زمان فصل کرونایی بود، زمانی که ما درک کردیم که فقر میتونه چقدر کشنده باشه و مرگی که از طریق فقر بیاید بسیار دردناک است. با عنوان یک جوان ما تیمی از جوانان جمع شدیم تا اینکه بتانیم که حداقل برای خود ما و برای اطرافیان ما بتانیم که مفید واقع شویم و کارآفرینی بکنیم.
Her aim was to revive the use of felt in art, a traditional textile in Afghanistan, to showcase her war-torn country's creativity and to try to create jobs for young people hit hard by the pandemic and the economic crisis it has caused. Kunal Shrestha, a 9-year-old boy, is a talented football fan from India's northeastern Manipur state. Kunal is specially abled as he only has one limb. However, with his love for the sport, he started playing the game, overcoming all challenges and hurdles in the way, and hopes to score goals soon.
9-year-old Kunal Shrestha from the capital city of northeastern Manipur state is an ardent fan of football who has proved that a firm determination and dedication can scale up highest of challenges. Kunal, who has one limb, has shown that there just needs to be enough courage and love the sport for overcoming all difficulties. Kunal, a class 4 student, had developed a love for football, kicking pomelo in the fields.
Tata, of confidence a gaya.
To dost log nahi bolte the aapko khelne se mana nahi karte pehle.
Dost support mein.
Kunal's mother said she always vowed to never let her kid feel different from his peers. She expressed as how a 9-year-old has never exhibited low esteem. During the COVID-induced lockdown, the kid was assisting his mother in preparing popsicles and snacks. The family then used to sell them in the locality.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.